Hello everyone, in this different kind of video that we normally don't publish to our YouTube channel, we will show you how to make a YouTube video, or how Stefano and I create our great content, and how we come up with our material, what programs we use, and just give you some general tips and tricks for your own YouTube channel. Think of this video as a behind the scenes, or maybe as a little tutorial for new YouTubers. We hope that you learned something interesting, and if you are new to our channel, welcome to our little community. Enjoy the video. Now let's get started. First of all, we start to think of the next best idea for a video that seems interesting, entertaining, and something that appeals to our subscribers and the YouTube community. It has to be something relevant to our niche as a channel, whilst also being something new that we haven't tried, or think that our audience might like. So, we begin to write a rough script with our ideas, letting every artistic idea flow, and later modifying it as our final draft. At the same time, we research any information that we need from the most reliable sources as possible. This could be anywhere, but we try our best to find the same fact from multiple places and do as much research as possible to find the best information for our YouTube videos. Then we record the script. We do this in turns. Usually Aaron will do the English and pronounce some foreign words, while Stefan narrates the Italian and Neapolitan words and phrases. He may also alternate between English and his languages at times. We record separately to ensure we have the best quality versions of our audio and script, with the best pronunciations and emphasis on certain information or words. Aaron tries his best to speak in a much more British received pronunciation accent, which is his best attempt at a simple and standard version of the English accent, as contrast to his own accent of Birmingham. That is to ensure that his own accent seems cleaner and can be understood by a wider audience all over the world. The next step is to download all of our audios and also the footage, clips and images that we plan to use for the video, keeping in mind the rules of copyright, which is really important if you want to become a good content creator on YouTube. The music from YouTube then comes next, and we usually find this from the YouTube studio due to the fact that it's royalty free, which means that the music is free and also there's no worry of copyright, and we don't want to include the long list of features of the artists and companies involved in the music in our description. This saves us much more space in our description for other information that we want our viewers to know and see. Next is to start to edit the audio and to clean it up. By this I mean to cut out any distracting background noises and general distractions from when the speaker is speaking. Some examples may include aeroplanes, birds singing, dogs barking, breathing noises whilst recording, any stuttering, or being unable to pronounce a phrasal word or make any other kind of mistake. This all helps by making our audio appear clean, understood, and much more professional. It takes a while and can get boring, but this is the best way to show your audience that you care and want them to hear in the very best quality that you can provide at this time. Once the editing of the audio is complete, we import the footage, clips and photos, adjusting them in time with the correct audio and words in our audios, so that the whole video is much more easy, interesting and also an enjoyable visual experience. Only the highest quality of videos would be best to use, as nobody wants to see errors or damage their eyesight whilst trying to learn new things and discover your content. Once we have finished most of the project, we check our project by adding some last minute touches, such as transitions or text, or anything that may have been missed, or think would be smoother in the finished video. Finally, we normally add the music and our intro and endings to our video at the last moment. This is to concentrate more on the audio and the visuals of the video that we edited earlier on. Now the video is complete. So, we export the video and then wait until it's finished, so that we can see the video in its finished form and to check if there's anything that we're not happy with. If there is something wrong or any errors, then we go back to the editing process and adjust them according to the just exported video, and then modify it and re-export it. We continue this until we are 100% happy with the final product. Then we ask the other partner, who has not yet seen the video, to check it one more time. So it's like a little bit of market research, for unbiased opinions, thoughts, questions, and also being able to notice any errors that we have maybe overlooked. When everything is perfect, we then create an interesting title, an important and helpful description, and think of relevant tags for our video. We usually do this on WordPad, as it's simple and easy. We also use online spell checks and character count tools online to check if everything is correct, relevant, and fits with our YouTube style and YouTube rules. After that step, we begin to design and create the thumbnail as a team using Photoshop. We play around until both of us are happy with our final thumbnail. These can be changed and updated in the future, so don't worry. We too have changed ours in the past. It's all about growing and learning as content creators. You learn what works and what doesn't. Once happy with everything, we upload it to YouTube with our titles, descriptions, tags, our great thumbnail, end screens that relate to the video or any website links that we use. Also, you may add subtitles. If you feel that the YouTube automatic subtitles don't work or are completely wrong, you can import them yourself. Then we decide which playlist it should be in, if it does need a playlist in the first place. There are more options that you can fill in, according to who, what, where, when, why, and how you want your video to be seen and perceived. Finally, once we check that everything is perfect and to the best of our ability, we change the status from unlisted, which is great for seeing if your video can be monetized and if there are any copyright problems. We change it to public, for everyone online to now see and enjoy our newest video. Then we await feedback, their comments and questions, so that we can grow as a channel and as a little community that we hope to build. This helps us to learn to make better content for next time. And that's it. We hope that you enjoyed this different kind of video, guys. It's just one of the many different behind the scenes kind of videos that you can find on our Patreon page, alongside extra content, lessons, scripts, tips and more. Our Patreon is in the description of this video if you're interested in coming over. If you enjoyed this kind of video, please give this video a like. And don't forget to subscribe. See you all soon.